Hello, my dear students, welcome back and welcome to the lecture series on work system engineering. Here we are on lecture number 27 on rating methods, because in our previous lecture we had already started with the basic definition of what do you mean by rating. We already went through what do you mean by basic time, and we saw what is a standard time. We also learned about qualified worker. So now it's time to know, like, you know, what are the various methods of rating. So let's go through the presentation without wasting the time. Let's move through the presentation on rating methods. The first one to deal is speed rating. It is also known as pace rating. And in few textbooks, it's also given as informal rating. Now, this is a procedure which comprises of judging the pace, also known as speed, of an operator or worker with respect to the movement in relation to a normal pace judged by the time study personnel, and is noted as a factor which we call it as a rating factor. Now, the rating is applied to each and every element. What is an element? We have already studied it in our previous lectures. How to break a specified job or a work cycle into an element, that also we have studied. So kindly go through the previous lectures to understand it in a much better way. Then the observed time for each element is multiplied by the rating factor to get the normal time for the element. This rating method is the most simplest one. It is known as informal because the normal pace for a worker's movement is decided by the time study personnel completely based on his judgment. There is no other base for it. And once he decides, the rating factor for a standard normal pace becomes 100. Whoever performs in a much speedier manner becomes a better performer and is rated more than 100. And the one who underperforms, whose speed is lower than the standard performance, is rated below 100. Then comes the second method, which is known as Westinghouse system of rating. Now, this comprises of a four-factor system for performance rating developed at Westinghouse. The four factors which are considered are skill, effort, conditions, and consistency. It is based on a tabular form, which you can see over here. Skill, effort, conditions, and consistency. Now, each of these four factors are again subdivided into six levels. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In that, the skill and effort, which has these six levels, each level for skill and effort is again subdivided into 2 degrees, except for the average. Average has only one, that is 0.00D, 0.00D. Whereas conditions and consistency, each of the six levels are having 1 degree each. Now, what does it say? It says like the skill ranges from 15% at a higher level to minus 22% at a lower level. For effort, plus 13% at the highest level, minus 17% at the lowest level. For conditions, plus 6% at the highest level, minus 7% at the lowest level. Similarly, for consistency, 4% at the highest level, minus 4% at the lowest level. Now, when I say that each of these level for skill and effort has 2 degrees, that means I may put the worker into the range of 15%, that is the highest, topmost 15%, or he may be in this 13% thing, but he is still in the super skill level. Or if I say he is poor, he may be in the bottom, that is like minus 22%, or he may be in minus 16%. Obviously, this person is better than him, but he's still in the poor condition when it comes to skill. Similar thing goes on with effort, conditions, consistency. Now, once for a worker, everything is calculated. Like for a worker, I see what is like, you know, for example, I say he's having 15% of skill, and then I say 10% of effort, then I say 4% of say condition, and then say he's average when it comes to consistency. It need not be that he is having all the things at the higher level. That is how it becomes a better option than the previous one, which is speed rating, which was only based on the pace. Now, once I get to know about each individual factor of that worker, then I sum this up. So I said 15 here, then I said 10, so that becomes 25. And then I said saying 4, so 29, and then I say 0. So I'm just rating him saying that he is 29%. I hope that is clear to you. That's what it said. The time obtained from the time study is then leveled by applying the sum of the rating for all the four factors. So these both systems are very clear to you. Let us move to the third system, which is known as the objective rating. This is done in two stages. In this technique or in this method, the rating is accomplished with two stages, wherein the first stage, the operator speed is rated just by observation of the pace of the movement, and no attention is given for the difficulties which is there in the job. Okay, that means a kind of what we did in our speed rating. The first part is similar to what we did in our speed rating. And then in the second stage, an allowance of secondary adjustment is added to the pace rating by considering the job difficulties. So there are, you know, 6 clauses for that job difficulties, which are the amount of body used, the foot pedals, the bimanualness, the eye-hand coordination while doing the work, the handling of the equipment and as per the requirement, and the weight. So these are the 6 clauses on which the job difficulties are categorized. And then the rating factor is calculated with the formula R is equal to PD, wherein P is the pace rating factor, which was earlier directly known as R for us, right? As per the speed rating. But now R is equal to, this becomes P, and then you have a factor D, which is the job difficulty adjustment factor in percentage. It's the average of all this. Now comes the next one, synthetic rating. Now this method is based on PMTS, that means predetermined motion time system, standard predetermined motion time system. In this procedure, the time study is conducted in a very usual manner, and then the actual time obtained for certain elements, not all, but certain elements from the complete study are compared with that known standards. So say there are 6 elements, you may tend to choose only 2 or 3, depends on you, and then you will be comparing the actual standard with the given standard for those 2 or 3 components.
The ratio of standard time of a particular element to that of observed time to the same element is rating factor for the study. And then what you do is, once you get for those three elements, since we chose only three here, so you'll be taking the ratio of the standard time and the observed time for those three elements out of six, and then you will determine the rating factor for the complete numerical, or you know, I cannot say it as a numerical, but yes, if you want to get an average rating, then what you are going to do is you will take the average of those three, and then the rating factor for the study becomes the average of the rating factors obtained for those three elements. If it is two, then two elements. If it is, you have 10, 15 elements and you have taken for 5, then the average of 5 elements for that study. This method of rating has two main advantages over the other methods that we have discussed. It does not rely on the judgment of time study person, obviously, because it is based on the standard time observation, PMTS. And then also it gives a consistent result. The thing what I was saying, that you have to find the ratio, it's mathematically given by R is equal to P by A, where P is the predetermined time value or the observed value, and A is the actual time value. Now, here's the thing for you. I'm sure you would have gone through all the lectures by now, especially on the time method, or sorry, the time study, including today's lecture and previous few lecture. I would like you to solve these problems and post your answers in the comments so that I can see how this lecture is engaging you. So kindly read them appropriately and try to solve them and answer them as quick as possible. Coming to the last part, or you can say the last type, it is known as the physiological evaluation of performance level. Now, this is a very different type from all others. A kind of biological thing. Yeah, I say that because the whole rating depends on your heart rate and oxygen consumption, you know. So, yeah, it is a proved fact saying that the heartbeat could be taken as a base for rating a person. I know it's wonderful and strange also, but then it's true. So in this method, the rating of operator is done on the basis of the heartbeat rate, that's per minute, and the oxygen consumption in calories per minute. I know, like directly we cannot get calories per minute. So it's a conversion actually, say calories per liter and then multiplied by 5 liters per minute kind of thing. So you tend to get the things in calories per minute. Anyways, that is none of the concern at present. We'll be seeing that maybe during the lab experiments. So coming to the next point, how it is done, like how do we standardize the thing? It's like, it's assumed that an operator who works on a job for which there is a time standard and that the number of pieces produced are as per the standard shows that his or her performance level is 100%. And then during this time, the operator's heart rate and oxygen consumption level are measured. So it's like, you know, the moment you decide that, okay, this is the right pace of his, this is with his 100% pace that he's working, And at that moment, you measure his heartbeat and oxygen consumption rate. And then if the heartbeat is at a higher side, then he is like doing it at a higher pace. And if it is like lower than that, then it means that he is doing it at a very slow pace. So good. This, you know, like something very different. And we do measure it using a treadmill or something. There are experimentation on this. And as I said, like, you know, these are all experimental work, the physiological evaluation, and we can check it out, like for those people who have labs on this. And yes, we have a lab work on this, so we will be looking at it at a later stage. So for those who have not seen the earlier questions, I will, you know, request you to pause the video, you know, to revert back to that section, pause the video, have a look at it, note down the question appropriately, and then solve it, comment the answer just below this video with your name.
So that was all about you know, the methods of rating. Yes, apart from that, there's something known as scales of rating, but then we are not dealing very much in detail about that, because the reason is, though there are several scales of rating, we stick on to mostly the British scale of rating, which is 0 to 100, wherein like 100 represents the, when you say 0 to 100, it does not mean that the 100 is a maximum one. 100 represents that average level, which is like you know, at a standard rate. Okay, we have been talking about this, right? 100 is a standard rate, so that is what we follow, like British scale. So whatever is above that, it's you know, the overperforming one, and whoever is below that, that's a underperformer. So that's why we are not going to deal much with that scale of rating. Otherwise, you know, the important one was the method of rating, and which we have covered over here. So I hope that you'll be going through this video carefully, because there are a few questions which you have to solve, and let me know. And as I said, you that kindly comment on you know, like same channel, like below this video, you can comment with your answers. So all the best, study well, and you know, be safe, take care of yourself and your family. Thank you.